Good afternoon to all. My name is Niranjan Behra. I am here to presenting a presentation on the topic of performance study of pervious concrete as a road pavement infrastructure system. The author of the paper sir, Mr. Sujit Kumar Pradhan sir, Niranjan Behra and Anil Palai. My presentation content, introduction, objective, materials, methodology, result, conclusion and reference. Introduction. The basic composition of pervious concrete is same as of conventional concrete with a little fine or no fine aggregate, which leads to make pervious concrete as a porous material. Due to this, pervious concrete create an interconnected void network that allow the water to percolate through the pavement. It can be used to infiltrate water coming from different sources to pavement surface to other media like groundwater table, rainwater harvesting system, underground water extraction channel, etc. And by this process, wastage of rainwater and artificial flood condition can be reduced. Pervious concrete come up with an extra flexibility for architect to create granary and parking lots. Pervious concrete is an eco-friendly construction material and EPA has also pointed out that it is a best management practice for stormwater management. Due to presence of void in it, the surface area increases and reduces pavement temperature quickly. Objective. Determine the physical properties of pervious concrete like compressive strength, tensile strength, flexural strength and permeability. Then develop a relationship between strength, permeability and percentage of fine aggregate. Materials. Cement is used to create the bond between aggregate. OPC is used for better strength and durability as compared to other type of cement. And generally OPC is used for construction of road pavement structure. OPC 43 grade is best for construction purpose. Water. For strength characteristics point of view, water cement ratio is more important. For better strength, we consider 0.34 water cement ratio from journal. If water content is lower than the optimum, then the bond between aggregate can't achieved. If high, then the cement paste behave as a fluid material and flow to the bottom of the pavement and block the pores and permeability affected. If we take the optimum water cement ratio, then mix will be good, and for the reference you can see the three figure shown below. Here we use clear water for mix. If we remove impurities from that to better result. Main load carrying element of the concrete is coarse aggregates. For better result, we have to select a uniform grade. But to maintain permeability, we have to take care of the void network. So we take 20 mm passing and 16 mm retaining 15% of coarse aggregate, 16 mm passing and 12.5 mm retaining 25% of coarse aggregate, 12.5 mm passing and 10 mm retaining of 35% of coarse aggregate, and 10 mm passing and 4.7 mm retaining of 15% of coarse aggregate. While considering the above data, we follow the Rutherford method of gradation and physical properties of material. Fine aggregate. Fine aggregate are used to fill the void in the concrete and create the interconnecting bond between the concrete material. Here we consider zone 2 fine aggregate for test work. Our assumption follow the previous study by some authors. Methodology. Concrete mix. Here we adopt M35 grade conventional concrete because for better strength of pervious concrete, we have to select the grade between M25 to M45. According to IS 10262, the ratio of material for M35 grade concrete are 1 is to 1.4 is to 2 and cement aggregate ratio is 1 is to 3.4. Then we mix and cast in the required shape for determine the result and goes for curing of 28 days period. Strength characteristics, compressive strength. To determine compressive strength, we conduct destructive test using 150 mm cubes as per IS code recommendation with a loading rate of 140 kg per centimeter square per minute or 22.1 kN per meter mm square per second. Load apply till the crack develop. Split tensile strength. To determine split tensile strength, we conduct indirect tensile strength. Apply the compressive load at the lateral surface to find the tensile strength of the cylinder using 150 mm into 300 mm cylinder as per IS recommendation with a loading rate of 17.25 kN per second. Load applied till the crack develop. To determine flexural strength, we conduct 2-point load test using 100 mm into 100 mm into 300 mm bar as per IS recommendation with a loading rate of 29.5 Newton per second. Load applied till the crack develop. Angularity number. Angularity number is determined from the solid point of view. To determine the angularity, pour the aggregate in the testing cylinder and determine the mass of the aggregate as per IS recommendation. And then determine the volume of the cylinder by water and determine the angularity number using the specific gravity of the aggregate. For calculate the void, total void in it, we add 33 in angularity number to determine. To calculate the angularity number, the formula is shown in the slide. Permeability. To determine the permeability, here we use constant head permeability method. Place the equipment over the sample as shown in the figure and then pass the water of 1000 ml at a constant head. Then using the constant head formula to determine the pavement permeability, where K is the permeability, V is the total volume of water is passed, L is the length of the sample, and T is the total time required to pass the water, and H is the constant head height, and A is the area of the patches. Result and discussion. Blue line represents the angularity number here, and gray line represents the total void in aggregate. As fine aggregate added the void content and angularity number decreases gradually due to fine aggregate occupy the void in coarse aggregates. While angularity number varies from 5 to 12 and total void content varies from 38 to 45. Strength characteristics. First graph is for compressive strength, next one is for tensile strength, and last one is for flexural strength. From this graph, we observe that the increase in percentage of fine aggregate, the characteristic strength of concrete increases. As compressive strength varies from 9 MPa to 20 MPa, tensile strength varies from 1.3 MPa to 2.8 MPa, and flexural strength varies from 1.4 MPa to 2.6 MPa. This happened due to addition of fine aggregate, reduce the void content of the concrete, and create more bond between the aggregate to carry more load. Permeability. The above graph represents the variation of permeability with respect to the percentage of fine aggregate. From this graph, we observe that the increase in percentage of fine aggregate, the permeability of concrete decreases. Permeability varies from 0.9 cm per minute to 1.01 cm per minute. This happened due to decrease in void content inside the pavement structure due to addition of fine aggregate. Optimomics. Optimomics graph provides a brief knowledge about the how compressive strength and permeability varies with respect to fine aggregate. For practical use, if we know our required strength and permeability, we can select the fine aggregate percentage and can use. If we found that our both parameters are high, then we have to negotiate with one parameter to construct the pavement surface. Conclusion. Here we conclude that the angularity number, total void content, and permeability decrease with increase in fine aggregate percentage, and vice versa. Similarly, characteristic strength increase with increase in fine aggregate percent, and vice versa. Above graph can be used for determining the required composition of concrete. References. Thank you, everyone. Any questions, please?